Welcome to this video tutorial on pernicious anemia. Pernicious anemia is an autoimmune disorder in which the body does not produce enough healthy red blood cells due to its inability to absorb vitamin B12. Pernicious anemia is caused by a lack of intrinsic factor, or IF, in the stomach, which causes B12 deficiency. Pernicious actually means deadly and is used because it was once considered a deadly disease due to the lack of available treatment. However, even today, failure to diagnose and treat in time can result in severe neurologic complications, leading to death. The disease was first clearly described in 1849 by Thomas Addison, from which it acquired the common name of Addison's anemia. It may also be referred to as vitamin B12 deficiency. Intrinsic factor is a protein produced by the parietal cells of the gastric mucosa, or stomach lining, that is necessary for the absorption of vitamin B12 later on in the small intestine. Vitamin B12 is not produced by the body and must be obtained from the diet. B12 is naturally found in animal products, including meat, poultry, fish, eggs, and dairy products. Fortified cereals and nutritional supplements are another source. When vitamin B12 is consumed, it travels to the stomach where it binds with intrinsic factor, or IF, and the two are then absorbed in the last part of the small intestine. In most cases of pernicious anemia, the body's immune system attacks and destroys the cells that produce IF in the stomach. When these cells are destroyed, the body can't make IF and therefore can't absorb vitamin B12. Sometimes other causes of vitamin B12 deficiency, such as poor diet, are confused with pernicious anemia. However, pernicious anemia is strictly caused by a lack of IF, whether that be due to an autoimmune disorder, gastrectomy or gastric bypass surgery, or a genetic defect in which a child is born not making intrinsic factor. Without enough B12, the body will produce macrocytes, or abnormally large red blood cells, which may not be able to enter the bloodstream from the bone marrow, resulting in a decrease in oxygen-carrying red blood cells in the bloodstream. Pernicious anemia is sometimes called megaloblastic anemia because of the abnormally large size of RBCs produced. It is not preventable and occurs in about 1 in 1,000 people, usually between the ages of 40 to 70 years. Patients with pernicious anemia often have other autoimmune disorders, as well as a 2 to 3 times increased risk of gastric cancer. The signs and symptoms of pernicious anemia are usually subtle and vague, and many are due to anemia itself. There is a triad of classic symptoms including weakness or fatigue, sore tongue or glossitis, skin tingling or paresthesia. However, these are not always seen in all patients. Additional symptoms include, but are not limited to, slight jaundice, pale skin with dark circles around the eyes, thinning and early graying of the hair and brittle nails, headaches, low-grade fever, depressive mood, a swollen red smooth tongue, sores at the corner of the mouth known as angular chylitis, loss of appetite and weight loss, pica, which is the desire to eat ice or other non-food things such as dirt or paper, tachycardia, chest pain, and the evidence of congestive heart failure, altered blood pressure, shortness of breath, and nerve damage, which can be permanent if treatment is not started within 6 months of symptoms. Severe pernicious anemia can lead to neurological symptoms, including an unsteady gait or clumsiness, stiffness and tightness in the muscles, numbness in arms and legs, dementia, psychotic depression or psychosis, progressive lesions of the spinal cord, and death in serious cases. Diagnosis of pernicious anemia involves several tests, a CBC, or complete blood count, a blood smear, vitamin B12 deficiency blood test, intrinsic factor antibody blood test, evaluation of gastric secretions, a stomach biopsy to look for cell damage, and the Schilling test. However, it is no longer widely used. Treatment for pernicious anemia involves administration of vitamin B12, either cyanocobalamin or hydroxycobalamin, which will stop anemia-related symptoms and neurological deterioration. If neurological problems are not advanced, complete remission of all symptoms will occur as long as B12 is supplemented. Standard treatment of B12 is usually by intramuscular injection, but oral doses also appear to be effective. Other methods include sublingual and intranasal treatment and experimental transdermal patches. Patient follow-up is required to make sure they respond to therapy and that they continue to receive therapy for the rest of their lives. B12 therapy resolves the anemia, however, it does not cure the chronic inflammation of the stomach mucosa, which can progress to gastric cancer. When caring for the patient with pernicious anemia, the nurse should remind patients that their family members are at a greater risk of developing the disease and should be monitored for anemia and mental or neurological symptoms. Teach the patient about eating a diet rich in vitamin B12. Instruct strict vegetarians, particularly those who do not eat eggs, milk, or meat, to take supplementary B12 for their lifetime, especially during pregnancy and breastfeeding. Let's take a look at a quick review of pernicious anemia. The body requires vitamin B12 and the protein called intrinsic factor, or IF, to make red blood cells. Pernicious anemia is an autoimmune disorder in which the body doesn't produce enough healthy red blood cells due to its lack of IF and inability to absorb vitamin B12. The three symptoms seen most often include weakness and fatigue, sore tongue, and skin tingling. If not treated, symptoms can become more severe, leading to death. Treatment involves lifelong administration of B12, but a person that is well treated can live a healthy life. Thank you for watching this video tutorial on pernicious anemia. Don't forget to subscribe and like us on Facebook, and take your vitamin B12.